The Prophet described the stairway in which they ascended to heaven, and he said, it's the stairway of the soul. When each person dies, his soul ascends on this stairway. That is if a person was virtuous, of course. But if he wasn't, he would not see such a stairway and would not ascend to the heavens on it. The Prophet, peace be upon him, ascended with Jibreel to the heavens, and in the first heaven he saw Prophet Adam until he reached the seventh heaven, where he met Prophet Ibrahim and found him sitting, leaning his back on the frequented house. Imagine how comfortable that is. Where? In the seventh heaven. Prophet Ibrahim welcomed the Prophet, peace be upon him, and there Prophet Ibrahim offered us a gift to me and you and to every human being, a gift from Prophet Ibrahim, peace be upon him. Two things. Prophet Ibrahim gave two things to the nation of Muhammad. First, he said, O Muhammad, you're here to meet your Lord, and your nation is the last and weakest of nations. All the nations were before us, and we are the last of nations, and we're the weakest and the last of the nations. If you can name all the needs of your nation and ask everything for your nation, then do so. You are going to ask God, so ask Him for your nation. Your status is known, and your Lord already gave you a high status, but the problem is in those who will come later, meaning us. Prophet Ibrahim told Prophet Muhammad to remember us. So what should we do in return for what Prophet Ibrahim did to us? What can we offer him? We can't offer anything for Prophet Ibrahim apart from listening to his words and obeying his words and to do exactly as he told us. That was the first thing he told the Prophet, peace be upon him. The second thing, Ibrahim said to Muhammad, peace be upon him. He said, tell your nation, peace be upon you. This means Prophet Ibrahim greets us. Prophet Ibrahim greets you and all the nation of Muhammad, all those who believe in Allah, His angels, prophets, who believes in Muhammad and the Day of Judgment. Tell them I said peace be upon you. He said that. Reply with peace be upon you, Prophet Ibrahim. He greeted us. We should greet him back. And tell them that paradise is empty and its land is fertile. He said it's empty. The paradise is so big and its land is fertile, yet it's empty with no trees. It could be yours, since there's a part of paradise designated to each person and another one in hell. You should know that. All depends on your deeds. The more good you do, you become closer to paradise. The more bad you do, you would deviate and get closer to your place in hell. Your place in hell would be inherited if you're not of the people of hell. And if a person were to be of the people of hell and not of paradise, others would inherit his place, they'd inherit his paradise, and he would be of the people of hell. Prophet Ibrahim advised us, saying paradise is vacant, meaning it's empty, and its plants are glory be to God, praise be to God, there's no God but Allah, and Allah is greatest. This was a gift from Prophet Ibrahim.